All right, just finished our first cup of coffee. And then we're taking our little mud on a walk.
Goosey looking for some bunnies. His favorite thing to do. Up and down the grasses. We're gonna go back to the house, do a little workout. I am not feeling it today. I'm tired. I feel like my body like can't wake up.
It's just Monday. Like, on Mondays, you have to force yourself up.
I know. I just feel really like I'm dragging. Like I'm not getting that spurt. Usually I'm like, okay, I'm awake. I could do this. It's not happening today at all. I'm just like, oh, I just want to go to sleep. Like I feel rested though. I feel definitely like rested.
Yeah.
I don't feel like too tired or anything, but I just feel laggy today. Like,
yeah, totally. Ugh.
Anyways, okay. Next up is our workout. You always hit on the nose, but never know how you could know. But treat me like a, treat me like a. I don't know that. Alrighty, just finished the workout. That was like, took everything that I had to do that. Ugh. But I mean, I'm glad I did it. I'm gonna get in the shower. I need to wash my hair, shave my legs, do all the things. So actually, I'm trying out Billy's razor. I've never tried their products before and I'm really excited. They are, obviously, they are like a shaving brand. So they are known for their Billy razor, which is, I've heard so many people, oh, hello, talk about it. Here it is, very aesthetic and cute. But I've never actually tried it, so I'm excited to try it today. It has charcoal in the razor, which is really amazing. So what's cool about them is that you get like the razor, basically like a starter kit for $9. So that's way more affordable and better quality than like a drugstore razor. And then when you need your refills, you get 4 razor heads for $9, which is also cheaper. I feel like razors in the drugstore are like $30 for like 4 razor heads, which is just ridiculous. And you can just order it online and they'll ship it to you. I also got some shave cream, so I'm gonna go ahead and use these in the shower. I'm really excited and I'll show you, or I'll tell you guys like what I think after, but I'm just assuming that I'm really gonna like it. I could let you have it, you could be my heaven, you could be my woman, right? I don't want you having. Anytime I know you're living in a home. Anytime I know I could let you have it, you could be my heaven, you could be my woman. Okay, I feel like I understand why everyone is obsessed with that razor now, because it actually is really good. It's like really sharp, but like it glides super smooth and it makes shaving like really fast. Like you can tell it's like getting a really close shave and it's like amazing. So love the Billy. I would highly recommend it. And but I just applied some moisturizer. I also got this salve in this like pink color. It's kind of tinted, so feel like a little tint to your lips. It's cute. And I'm very, very satisfied. So I'll have Billy's info linked in the description box down below. Really, really good razor. That was absolutely excellent. So I'm very happy. Okay, I'm gonna get dressed and get ready for the day. I'm feeling like a little tired. I feel like HIIT workouts, when they're really like active like that, they make me really tired. So I'm gonna try get my energy up. I need to meal plan for the week and head to the grocery store and catch up on work. So let's get ready. They say good feelings are your guardian angels, angels. And I know my good feelings were my guardian angels. And I should have listened to them. I should have listened to them. I should have listened to them.
made some avocado toast, banana. Hunter's eating oatmeal. And we're gonna get to work. Okay, so I am all ready. I've been working this morning and making a little meal plan, and I am gonna go to Costco this week just to kind of switch it up. I've been going to a regular store, and I kind of like make different things based on the stores that I go to because they like have different things that they're good at, if that makes sense. So today I'm hitting up Costco because I also need to get dog food for Goose. That's where we get his dog food. I'm hoping that they still have it. And a few other like kind of Costco-y items. So I just figured I would go there this week. So I have been taking the opportunity whenever I go to the store or go out of the house to kind of like get dressed normally. So that's what I've done today. So this is what I'm wearing. Let's see if it'll, oh yeah, there we go. So these are the tanks. This is the black tank from my Boohoo athleisure video. They're like the perfect little simple high neck crop tank. This one's black. I also have white. And then these are shorts by A. Goldie. I love them. They're gonna be a perfect short for summer. They're not too short, which I love. They're, gosh, what's the name of them? I forget, but I'll link them below. And then this jacket was also in my Boohoo video. It's like a plaid sand and white beige oversized jacket. I'm wearing a size 10, but I think it looks really cute, like layered over something a little bit more fitted. And then my Prada boots, which there are dupes for, so I'll link dupes for them as well. But yes, this is what I'm wearing. Oh, and my necklace is Lily Clasp. It's just like my herringbone necklace. So yeah, I feel it's nice to like put on a real outfit and everything, but I'm gonna go to the store. I'll bring you guys along. Well, actually probably shouldn't bring the camera in there just because it's sensitive and I don't want to get it like germy and stuff. So I'll see you guys after the store.
Alrighty, we're headed to the store and this is just crazy. Like I feel like you kind of forget that there's like what's going on in the outside world, and then you leave the house and you're like, oh yeah, like that's when it really like hits kind of, because you can kind of like just check out and go into your own bubble like when you're at home and you're not like seeing anybody or anything. Oh gosh, I did actually get some questions when I did my Q&A on Instagram, like kind of how are you dealing with this like mentally and everything, and it's been kind of like a roller coaster up and down. I think it's just overall, it's just kind of like sad. The whole thing is just like sad. I feel sad for just this. It's almost like a mourning of like a death or something. And I read an article, actually, I posted it on my stories a while back, but it's, and that's exactly like what the article said. It's like, you're basically mourning like a life, you know what I mean? Like you're going, you have to like allow yourself to like grieve for what life used to be and just kind of like letting go of that. And I think that's like what's really sad. It's kind of like moving on and like getting over that, definitely for a while, because we know this will at least be like a month or two. I mean, I predict that it'll probably be longer than that. And it's just like kind of sad to like think about just not getting normal experiences or that time for a certain amount of time. So that's kind of what I'm going through. But on the day-to-day, I've been decently okay. I feel so lucky to still be able to work, even though it's definitely been quieter. So I am feeling that, and same with Hunter. But I don't know, I just feel, you know, I feel really lucky and fortunate to at least still have like an income. And I know there's so many people that are in way worse circumstances than I am. So that's just been my personal experience. And so with that, I'm just trying to take it as an opportunity. Really noticed the past couple weeks is that I felt like this has been a really big reflecting time for me, and in a way it's been kind of nice to not, like, once all of your distractions of life are kind of like stripped away and gone, like all social life, all like, you know, events, and those things are, in a way, they're just kind of like distractions sometimes, like from I don't know, I find it, it's like kind of the same way when you go away on a vacation and everything is super quiet and you're able to kind of just like see your life for what it is and kind of reflect on where you're at and what you want to like improve or what things are making you happy or what are not making you happy. And so I feel like this has been a similar time. Like for me, like that, I've been thinking a lot about like who I am and things I wanna like improve on. And I've just had like a lot of time alone, and as I'm sure we all have, just to like really think about my life and what I wanna do and the things that I'm like valuing and the things that I want to like make better. It's been nice to have that time to just really like think that through, and it's really hard to get in that mindset sometimes when there's so much going on and there's so many friendships and relationships and traveling and bouncing back and forth and work, and you know, it's just a lot. It's a lot of, like, up here. And so having that quiet time, really, I've just been able to like really think. So that's been kind of nice, and I'm still just kind of like working through all of that, like thinking about, yeah, life and stuff, and like things I want to change about myself and improve, and you know, stuff like that. So, you know, Hunter and I are in a kind of a unique spot because we are a couple years away from having kids. We know that's like the next big chapter of our life, and so that's kind of like, we're in a very big moment because we're kind of, you know, preparing to kind of like adjust and transition into that eventually, even though it's not like ASAP. But you really start to think about like, okay, well, what am I gonna do, like what am I gonna do with my time before I enter that next phase, and like where am I at? So you start to think a lot of things. So I don't know, I'm probably not making any sense, but hopefully you guys know what I mean. Okay, I'm gonna drive to the store and I'll see you guys when I get out. I'll show you what I get when I get back. I'm gonna leave the camera in the car though, because I don't want it to get like infected or gross in the store.
What's up, Goose? Mom's home. We're gonna unload the groceries.
Hey, Goosey. Have you ever taken out food? Mm-hmm. Have you ever
So the highlight, I think, of Costco is that I got microwavable rice. Fun fact about me, I can't cook rice to save my life. So this is microwavable, which is exactly what we need, Goose. It's perfect, because we know you can't cook rice and neither can I. Yeah, for sure, because you don't got thumbs. I got microwavable rice. And nice. He said, me and Goosey need that because we know you can't cook rice and never gonna.
You can place the buttons on the microwave though.
And unloaded everything. I just filmed a little IGTV. I've been doing that like every week over on Instagram, with a detailed breakdown of like my menu plan and a full haul of like everything at the beginning of the week to give you guys ideas. And the reason I do it over there is because you can bookmark IGTVs, and I feel like for meal planning, at least for me, that's more helpful. So I can save it and refer back to it versus doing it here on YouTube. I think you kind of like lose track. So I've been doing it over there. Let me know if it would be better to do it here. I feel like that's working though. So hopefully you guys find that helpful.
I'ma go ahead and cut the leaf. I will stick around until you're lonely. I'm staying out of reach. If you're only working part-time, how can you expect a salary? How come you keep asking me for full price?
Wrong. Okay, so I'm gonna start preparing dinner. Story of my life. Every night at 6:30, it's like clockwork. And I am making tonight some salmon bowls. And I basically got this recipe from Savon Ayla. She is an blogger, Instagrammer. And she has this famous salmon bowl rice recipe. It's super simple. She's like, salmon, avocado, rice, and she does like an egg with it. Well, I'm gonna basically do that, but kind of do a little twist on it. So I'm gonna do my microwavable rice, which I got at Costco, I'm very excited about. That's gonna be my rice. And then I'm gonna do a lot of steamed broccoli. Like I will obviously not this all back, but I'm gonna just do like a lot of that with the rice. So for the salmon, I just line a cookie sheet with some foil. And here's my salmon. I just get the Atlantic salmon. And I'm going to literally plop it. I might actually cut it into portions. Scissors. Oh, whoopsies. Well, okay, let's see. Cut it, but then I'll probably. All right, so that's gonna go in at 425 for like 10 minutes, and then I'm gonna prep the other stuff.
This is also a little hack I have for fast steaming if you're in a hurry. So I put the broccoli in there, a little bit of water, and put a little saran wrap over it, and then poke holes in the top. I did probably like 10 holes. And then I put it in the microwave for 5 minutes and it steams.
Got our rice. All 90 seconds worth, which is amazing. Oh gosh, a lot. Perfect. Okay, so I'm just gonna do like a nice layer of rice. Less for me. Perfect. Then take my broccoli. Disperse that. Got it like that. And then I'm gonna take one of the salmons, just pull it off, put it right on there. I'll do a quarter on each. And her recipe, she does that sauce, so I'm just gonna pour that over top. I'm gonna kind of focus it on the rice and the vegetables. Okay, yum. Okay, cross our fingers and hope that it's delicious. It looks amazing.
I really need to get my wisdom teeth out.
They're hurting.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, blows.
All right, salmon bowls were excellent. I feel like they were maybe missing something, so I'm gonna have to fine tweak it, but I mean, totally good as, is.
I'm just all white.
Are you doing that stuff?
I was sanding the walls.
Trying not to get it all in the kitchen. yeah, but the salmon bowls are really good. I mean, they're good just like that. I'm just thinking like, there could be something to take them to the next level. I'm not sure what it is, but.
You needed a crunch.
A crunch.
Like maybe more of like a crunchy vegetable.
Yeah, I'll have to play around with it. That rice I think too wasn't like sticky enough. We need like a sticky
or
rice.
Or a spice.
Yeah, I need like a zing or like a sweet or like a something. But I have been seeing this vegan banana bread recipe from Emma McDonald. She's a YouTuber, she's younger, and she made this the other day and I've been craving it ever since. I've been waiting to find baking soda at the store, baking powder, and I found it. So I finally just put together the recipe. I'll link her video below. But oh my god, I already tried the batter out of the bowl and it was like crack. It's gonna be so good, but it's completely vegan and gluten-free. So mine's not gluten-free because I didn't have gluten-free flour, but yeah.
She don't know me, ooh, baby.
you in September, something I should do. Knew you in November, still I ain't pursued on you.
Okay, we are literally drooling this banana bread.
I smell freaking lit. I was working in my office and I came here and sat down with 5 minutes left on the
dinner. Hunter's like, I'm gonna eat 10 of those muffins.
Everything else comments right now from today's magic.
Yeah, we just watched the first one. I can't even describe the smell. It's like the best thing I've ever smelled in my life. Let me test. What? Oh yeah, these babies are done. Oh yes, I did some muffins. And then one little mini loaf. God. So I know you don't like chocolate, a lot of chocolate chips, so I did a couple with extra because I like that. And then yours, I did just the normal chips inside.
Oh, and I got so much dust on me still. What? I got so much dust on me. So, let me do this handy dandy sander sponge.
Oh, that looks good.
It's basically like a beauty blender, pretty much.
Beauty blender? It's
basically the same thing.
Not even that.
And see, like, now there's like not any little rivets.
So, any like spots so, like, that maybe that I did? There?
A little hole?
Yeah.
Goodbye. You might still be able to see that like round circle.
But you can't feel it.
But.
Okay, okay.
So now. Basically make it flat so when I paint it. Cause like when you paint, you can put paint on top of it.
Yeah.
I was testing it earlier. You'll be able to see like these lines.
Yeah.
I can't see.
Yeah, you can.
Or like that right there?
Yeah.
I don't want that showing.
That's the section I did.
Yeah. Your section was so shitty.
Hey, this is a little preview of what. Okay, this corner right there, that's what it's gonna look like. Well, with the paint, but white paint, black floors. So if you zoom in, that's kind of like a snippet of what it's gonna be.
I got too excited. I couldn't wait to see the wood underneath, so I pulled it back.
It looks so good.
A little snippet.
It's gonna look really, really good. You know, I'm worried that your furniture is gonna, like, there's gonna be so much furniture that's gonna take away. Refine it.
Yeah.
I'm like
so anal with this stuff. Like, I'm going by, like, feeling every, like, when I'm looking crazy.
Freak.
I'm a perfectionist. Like, I know. Really, with projects like that, I am embarrassed if it's not, like, too bad. Because I hold people that come do work on our house, I hold them to like that standard. So I want to be able to do it.
Right. Makes sense. Can I use that after you?
Sure. I mean, I'm about to dig in on these muffs.
Yeah. Going on the muffs.
We gotta make sure we pull them out.
They're gonna slide right out.
Why?
They're like,
oh wait, can we just like dump it?
Yeah, but just like
wait, those are melted, huh?
Yeah, babe, just
oh, look. No, they're not. They're good.
Look, literally, they lift out. They're so clean.
Okay. I was trying to do the pie trick, you know?
I know, but I know you like to have fun, but you kind of make a mess.
You make a mess. I clean up your mess. Are we pulling them all out?
No, I'm just getting one.
And that's the one you want?
Yeah.
So we're not sharing, huh? Okay.
No, we're not sharing. Oh my god. Wow.
So impatient.
I'm sorry, sometimes my patience.
It's only when you're hangry. But you're like, oh, you already had food. This is dessert.
Sometimes you annoy me. And sometimes I annoy you.
Goose.
Oh my god.
Too good this year. I'm sorry.
That is next level.
Oh. Sugar-free. Sugar-free, gluten-free, vegan.
Well. Just about. Only maple syrup, no sugar. I sprinkle a little salt on top of mine. Wow.
I wanna try one.
I
wanna try one.
What do you mean?
Are they good?
Try one of what?
These muffins. I feel like I haven't had one yet.
You just need another round to really understand if it's good or not.
Are they good?
Because there's absolutely nothing for you here. Nothing. You could sit and wish and dream, and it's never happening.
Hate to let you down. Sorry, Goose. You don't like bananas.
You know, yeah, you actually don't like bananas, so you don't get any.
You don't like bananas, and you're not allowed to have chocolate, so you're screwed.
You're screwed. This man is not for you.
Goose is, I told him he could go to sleep whenever he felt like it. Like, he's a teenager, he could do whatever he wants.
We've given you respectful boundaries, Goose.
We trust you.
Trust you, Goose, to make good decisions, but that doesn't mean you won't step in when you don't.
Exactly. Ooh, I'm in bed first. You have to shut off the light. You're not coming up on this bed. Do you want to bring his bed in here? He's been loving that. We need to get a second bed for the bedroom, I realized. For this little nougat.
I'm trying to give you your boundaries in your space.
I told you you could do whatever you wanted. You're grown up.
See, look, he gets excited. He gets excited. As soon as you grab the bed, his tail started wagging.
Are you going to sleep by dad?
I need to cover you from all the haters.
Goose, look at that tail. I can still see it.
Everyone wants to
see you on a walk. Yeah. Everyone wants to see you on a walk, Goose.
You have more fans than I do. Come on, Goose.
Perfect. Good boy. Okay, and good night. My hottie riding shoddy. I don't want nobody's body but your body, babe. All I'm trying to say is there's a difference between miss you and I miss your face. There's a difference in what's going on. Baby, how is your day? Yeah, there's a hell of a difference in saying three words.